My name is Miha Moškon, and I'm an associate professor at the Faculty of Computer Information Science at the University of Ljubljana. I'm a member of the Computational Biology group at the same faculty. I'm passionate about studying biology from a perspective of a computer scientist. One of the most rewarding things in my work is to study a biological mechanism in detail, replicate its dynamics in a computational model, and then observe it in a computer simulation, so to replicate living things inside a computer. I was always interested in different fields, but deciding to study computer science was partially also due to my family legacy, because both my father and my older brother have been working in this field. Later on, it was hard for me to stay within the borders of pure computer science. So I did my bachelor thesis on a computer model of collective behavior of birds. Later on, my work shifted to a smaller scale of biological systems, which was initiated with my participation in synthetic biology iGEN competitions, where Slovenian student team has been very successful. I did my PhD in the field of computational modeling of engineered biological systems as an alternative to digital electronic circuits. We are still working on the computational design of biological systems with information processing capabilities in the context of synthetic biology. But recently, our work has shifted more towards systems biology, where similar approaches are not used to design novel, but to study natural biological systems. Even though I mostly regard myself as a researcher, I'm a full-time teacher at the university. Finding a balance between research and teaching can sometimes be overwhelming. However, combining these two complementary disciplines often seems very natural, since one inspires the other. We are currently working on computational approaches for automated integration of large-scale omics data into different types of computational models. Examples of these include genome-scale metabolic models and Boolean models of gene regulatory networks. Data integration approaches allow us to adapt computational models to a specific biological context by using a reference model together with big data, usually omics data. For example, we can use a dataset gathered from a specific group of individuals to reconstruct a disease-specific model. Or we can use a dataset from a specific individual to reconstruct their personalized model. The models produced in such way are not only useful for the interpretation of given dataset, but also for the generation of new data, new hypotheses, their testing, etc. For example, we can produce a computational model of a specific disease and then test what happens if a certain perturbation occurs within the network. A perturbation might represent a change of a diet, knockout of a gene, or a drug intervention. The approaches we are working on can be applied in a wider scope of systems biology, but are also used to answer questions in medicine, especially in the context of complex system diseases. As the name suggests, these are systems disorders, which means that their occurrence cannot be pinpointed to a single cause, but are a combination of several factors which are hard to identify unless addressed from a systems perspective. This represents a shift from a reductionist approach, each part of the system is analyzed separately in isolation, to an integrative approach where a system is analyzed as a whole, since it is more than a sum of its basic parts. Computers have allowed us to study biological systems from such perspective. The field has made significant progress in recent years, especially due to the development of different high-throughput experimental techniques which are able to generate large amounts of data, and with the development of computational power and algorithms, which can be used to analyze this data very efficiently. Currently, we can reconstruct models of different cellular processes, but we are still coping with connecting these models into the whole systems. For example, to obtain a whole cell, whole tissue, or even whole body, whole organism models that would be scalable from simpler to complex organisms. This is essential for the future progress of the field, since no biological process works in isolation, and so the predictive power of isolated models is limited. For example, to accurately describe the metabolism, one must be able to connect its model with a model of gene regulatory and signaling networks. The modeling approaches used in each of these networks are advancing every day, and so are the approaches for their integration into more comprehensive models. I am confident that we will be able to address the model integration problem soon. In the context of medicine, this will allow us to reconstruct digital twin which represent a very accurate virtual representation of the human body. Of course, every human organism is different. In this context, a reference digital twin model will have a potential to serve as a reference or a scaffold model. Having appropriate algorithms and enough computing power will allow a physician to adapt a scaffold model to a patient-specific model in real time at the point of care using patient-specific data. Practical application of this can be a game changer for the healthcare industry. A physician will acquire the patient's data, for example, omics data, and integrate this data into a scaffold model to obtain its personalized model. The latter will then be used to identify the anomalies in the network, so to perform diagnostics, to identify the interventions that would bring the system back to its healthy state, so for personalization of therapy, as well as to simulate what would happen if certain interventions are or are not issued. Moreover, digital twins will be used to accurately track the progress of a selected therapy and to adapt this when necessary. One of the main challenges is availability of data in standardized machine-readable formats, but here we are talking about very sensitive data, so this issue needs to be addressed carefully and in long term. Another problem we as teachers can directly address is the readiness of the healthcare community to adopt computational modeling approaches. The practitioners of medicine are, in my opinion, conservative towards the use of these approaches, especially due to the knowledge gap between the medical education and the computational and mathematical sciences. We can address this gap by introducing different computational and bioinformatic courses to the curricula of medical faculties. This would allow us to educate new generation of medical doctors that will be able to address complex nature of complex system diseases more efficiently. And maybe we will soon have a new medical specialty, such as computational physician.